Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and warm welcome back to our Milwaukee webinar series. I'm Claude Aufrecht, I'm the training manager for Milwaukee here in Europe. And I'm really proud today to present you a complete new category for Milwaukee. We will dive deep into our lasers, and therefore I have the best support I can get in the company. With me here today is Raphael Schütt.
Thank you very much, Claude, for this warm welcome. And also welcome here on the webinar from my side. I'm working now since 2 years on the laser category. And when we were talking to you, you always were telling us, hey, when is Milwaukee coming with lasers? When are you gonna come with lasers and launching lasers? We need lasers. We heard you. But in order to deliver here the best in class lasers, we spent thousands of hours on job site to understand the situation on job site and also the frustration to develop best in class laser. When we talk about line lasers in general, line lasers really get used for several applications. One major application which using a lot of trades is the 1 meter reference. When you reference the line and you take the line really to bring in other areas on the construction side to work on the line, or also the electrician to work on the line to align your sockets in vertical applications and horizontal applications, or the drywaller, which is a heavy user for lasers as well, which using a lot of lasers every day, also require here a 90 degrees lineup. But here we are here now to understand what is Milwaukee gonna launch in terms of lasers. And I can tell you already, Milwaukee is completely focusing here on rechargeable solution with green lasers, providing all day runtime and uncompromised visibility with a high intensity green laser beam.
Hi Raphael, this is an important point because from research we know almost 50% of the market is still red. And now you tell us we go directly into green. Why that?
Claude, you're right. I know, I think in Milwaukee we love red. But when it comes to laser, we are all green. And this is because green is much better visible. We talk about 4 times better visibility on a green laser line versus a red laser.
Okay, let's check here. And as we can see on the picture, clearly, the green line is definitely better visible. So approved. It was a good decision. But I've also another question out of the research here. When we speak about, we go only into chargeable solutions. We know already the market is 60% alkaline. So why we are not going into alkaline?
Yes, Claude, the alkaline market is really big, but also gives us a big potential as well. When you go for an alkaline laser today, and this is really for all competitors, you have the compromise of runtime or visibility. The red laser line is really giving you more runtime. The green laser consumes much more energy, but gives you a better visibility.
Hey, Raphael. One question about the runtime. I have here one competitor laser, a laser we have seen on hundreds of job sites during our research. And it is a green alkaline. Can you give me an idea of the runtime of this laser?
Yeah, this laser, you have a runtime of 4 hours and then the alkaline battery run empty. With our red lithium USB solutions, we really provide here all day runtime. That means over 8 hours. And high intensity green laser beams gives you really a great visibility on the laser line.
But yeah, Raphael, also you told me the USB charging laser is a bit higher in the price than the alkaline.
Actually, Claude, on a short term, when you buy the tools, you are right. But on a long term, an alkaline solution is always more expensive. Okay, just to make it simple, one single red lithium USB battery is covering over 6,000 alkalines. And to make it even more clear, Claude, quick question. You as a former plumber, how often you were using lasers so during the week?
Oh, Raphael, it's very friendly that you think I'm that young. Hey, my plumbing times are 30 years ago. To be fair, to this time, it was purely man-made. But to remember from the research, we know a plumber uses laser approximately 3 hours a day, so I would say 15 hours a week.
Okay, that's a simple calculation. 15 hours a week means after half a year, actually, your red lithium USB laser it is paid off. And for the next year, you save money up to 200 euros. And for the entire life of a red lithium battery, you save up to 2,000 euros of alkaline costs.
2,000 euros in cost savings? Wow, that's my next trip to Australia. And where's your trip going? Raphael, I'm sure now it is time to go a bit deeper into our lasers.
Yes, Claude, we have here different versions of lasers here on the desk. We have the red lithium USB lasers. We're gonna have a cross line laser. This laser is projecting a horizontal line and a vertical line. And then we have a cross with two points, additionally projects a plumb point up and down.
Raphael, one important question I remember from the research. Nearly every user asked us, what's about the visibility range of the lasers?
Yeah, the visibility range here on red lithium USB is 30 meters. And also, when we look here on the red lithium with two points, we have here a riser you probably saw. This is just to lift up the tool slightly to make the plumb point visible, to adjust the laser here on your marks on the chop side, also to get over a floor track, to transfer the measurement from the floor to the ceiling. And then our M12 section here. Our M12 lasers is also, first of all, a cross with two-point laser combined with a 3-amp-hour battery, and then a three-plane laser, which is having 3 × 360 degrees lines combined with a 4-amp-hour battery. And it's also good here to also project a 90-degrees line on the floor, which is normally used by drywallers as well.
Yeah, Raphael, I understand. The three-plane for the drywallers is clear for me. But another question here is for me. We have this cross-line laser with plumb point. One time in M12, one in USB charging. Can you tell me, why should I buy the M12?
Good question, Claude. The M12 really is targeting the high-demand user. Users which require longer distance and longer runtime during the day. We talk about 15 hours of runtime on the M12 and 38 meter visibility in radius.
I think this is something we make to be clear. 30 meters in radius, guys, means 38 meters to the right, 38 meters to the left. This gives a total distance of 76 meters, so more than enough even for a large construction site.
Yes, Claude, and also the M12 is addressing for sure here the M12 user today, which is already in our system. We're providing up to 85 power tools around this single M12 batteries.
Yeah.
And also, let me say one more thing. For the whole range of the lasers here, we're really focusing here on end users, on our core end users like electricians, plumbers, HVAC, and for sure the drywallers as a heavy user of lasers.
Yeah, when we think for the users, guys, it's a point which I remember. When we saw users setting up their lasers on site, on a smaller place, on a smaller area, it could be a time of 5 minutes, but it's fine. But I remember also long distances and other problems, and it could last 25 minutes to set a laser up. And the question here for me is, did we develop something to make this job easier for our end users?
Yes, Claude. We developed a lot of solutions which really helps to set up the lasers, also in combination with our accessory. But I would like to point out one really important feature. This is the fine adjustment. The fine adjustment is coming with all the lasers. And when we look here on this competitor video, for example, it's really hard when you don't have a fine adjust to align two marks on the vertical line. You need to readjust the whole unit to get the marks aligned. And you can imagine, this is just an example. Usually on a job site, you have much longer distance. And the longer the distance, it harder gets to align the two marks. On this Milwaukee solution, you place the point laser first on the mark, and then you use the fine adjust to align on the second mark, which is a much faster solution.
Raphael, when we spoke about the lasers, we had also another function here. I think we need to speak about... No, sorry, my mistake. Raphael, I think we need to go here a bit deeper. I'm sure you've proved this on site.
Yes, Claude, for sure. A couple of weeks ago, I was in contact with a research contact from me. This is a professional plumber. His name is Theo, and I was talking to him. I gave him a prototype of the laser, and he's using the laser since 4 months. And he showed me a little bit how he sets up the laser. And he was pretty happy here with the setting up the Milwaukee laser compared to the laser he used before. But hey, let him talk on his own. What was his experience?
Okay, when you're setting up the laser, was there any experience with using the M12 Milwaukee
laser? Also ich stelle ja den Laser auf den Boden, auf meine Markierung. Und dann stelle ich das, kann ich sehr schnell einstellen durch die Feinjustierung. Und meine zwei Maße kann ich dann perfekt einstellen. Und dann durch die schwarze Zielscheibe kann ich sehr schnell orten, wo mein Laser ist.
Okay. When you say it's a fast setup, what does it mean when comparison to other lasers you had before?
Ganz einfach. Ich musste dann immer verschiedene Sachen einstellen, und zwar manuell. Und durch die Feinjustierung geht es sehr schnell mit den Rädchen. Und zack, habe ich schon. Und Geld ist Zeit und Zeit ist Geld. Und Geld habe ich immer keins, gell? Okay.
Yeah, guys, this stays on its own. This is a clear statement how easy it is to set up our lasers. And this brings me to another point, Raphael. When we spoke about the lasers, you mentioned a function pivot on point, and it took me some time to understand it. So I think it is worth to explain it again.
Okay, yeah, the pivot on point features you're gonna find on all cross with point lasers and on the three-plane laser as well. To easily give you an idea, if you're using here the vertical line first, and then on the distance, you're using the macro adjust to come close to your mark. Then you use the fine adjust to do the last bit. On our solution, the point will stay on position and will not move. That helps a lot to concentrate on the mark and distance to align the laser much faster.
Well, that's really simple and easy and efficient, Raphael. But I think now it is time for us to go a bit deeper into the functional elements of the laser, how to use our laser.
Okay, for an example, I'm gonna use here the red lithium USB cross laser. All the functionalities of the lasers are basically the same. So I go through the functions here quickly. We were talking about fine adjustment a lot. So here on this knob, you really can tune the laser from left to right, very fine on your marks. Then you can switch on the laser on this rotating button. And here on this position, you can use the laser at any angle. You're releasing here the self-leveling mode on the second mode, and it self-levels to 4 degrees. On the top of the laser, you can change then the modes to vertical or cross position.
Raphael, be a bit careful, my eyes.
Come on, Claude. This is only laser class 2. This is safe. If you just pass by with your eyes, no worries, nothing can happen.
That is brilliant.
Okay, but let's turn the laser around here. On the other side, we have here the USB port. And with the mini USB, you can easily charge the laser. And it also indicates to you how the laser is charged. Green means it's fully charged battery. You can charge it with a power bank. You can even use it in the charge mode. And it's also provided here a wall plug in the kit. So all the lasers coming here with the 360 rotation bracket with strong magnets, which can be fixed on all kind of metal materials. I will quickly show you here on this presenter desk how to fix it. So easy, it's magnets, but the magnets are as strong. Even when I push hard on it, it barely slides down.
Yeah, Raphael, come, don't cheat us. I have here the lightest battery I found in the Milwaukee range. Let's have a quick test. Are the magnets strong enough for this battery?
Okay, no problem. As you can see, there's absolutely no sliding, even when you put some weight on it. We're not cheating.
This is really strong, and even the material here is not that thick.
Correct. But hey, when I need to align the laser on your reference mark, I need to push a little bit, right?
Hey, Raphael, be a bit careful with my studio equipment. Yeah? I have the next webinar here in 2 weeks.
No worries, Claude. There is no metal-to-metal connection. All what you do is you're sliding it on the rubber points, and it makes some strange sound, but there's no metal and no scratches.
Hey, this is really a good feature. But I would say let's go a little bit back to the usage. And I would say every laser is only good as its accessories. And the first accessory I have here, it's the drag lip. The drag lip we deliver with every single laser kit. So it was for me always a little bit a problem to understand exactly the functionality. Again, I'm a plumber, so I'm sure Raphael can explain us here a bit more.
Yeah, the track clip really helps to align the laser vertically on your reference mark. It can be used on a ceiling application. You easily can clamp it to the ceiling track. And then with this centering groove, you really can align easily the laser on the track clip and can move it up and down to basically line it up to your reference line. We have another accessory, a really versatile accessory. This is the 360 mount. It can be used as a combination, as you can see here, with the track clip. So then you have an additionally fine adjust in the vertical mode to really fine tune the laser line on your reference marks. It can be used on horizontal positioning or vertical positioning with the 360 degrees rotation surface. You can mount the any laser always on the right side. And it's really comparable to all our laser, what we're launching now, to really, and here we see again, you can really fine tune the line with the fine adjustment in vertical position that helps a lot of time on the construction. And again, that saves time when you're setting up the laser.
Yeah, Raphael, these are accessories where I would say from time to time they are specialized for some user groups. But I saw on nearly every construction site a very important one I have here.
Yeah, Claude, we can't miss a tripod for sure. We have a tripod which can be elevated up to 1.80 meters, and it comes with a 1/4-inch reception which fits on almost all lasers on the market. And in combination here with the 360 mount, Claude, we have here a bottom mount solution. And this is really kind of a unique solution. But hey, help yourself. Try to fix the laser on it.
Of course. Hey, simple and easy. I just need to switch the laser on and it can work. And still I have the fine adjustment. Hey, Raphael, this reminds me of an electrician during our research. Can you remember this guy? A lot of sockets just above the floor, and he lift up his laser to level it on some buckets, I think some boxes, whatever he found, and it could be that simple.
Absolutely.
Hey, this is really a great feature. And again, guys, it is unique for Milwaukee. But thinking about research, I can remember some other situations. One was definitely working on a long distance. I think it was a plumber, and he has to install a pipe really on a long line. And he was alone, and he asked us to help him. And Raphael, you support him and guide him. Go a little bit to the left, a little bit. Stop. Ah, it was too much. Definitely, it was a hard job, and I'm sure every one of us has seen such things before. And I'm sure we developed here a perfect solution.
Yeah, Claude, we saw the situation really, and also the plumber. I gave him then a nice accessory, which is that high visibility target blade. And this target blade reflects the laser line when it hits the target and makes it much easier to align vertical lines on marks, especially when you use the laser on the floor.
Hey, Raphael, this is a great solution. Think back, a two-man shop down to a one-man shop. This saves really money. But let's speak about other situations. One I will also never forget. It was in the early summer. It was a very bright day, huge windows in the building, and it was really bright. And even on a short distance, we was not able to see the laser line anymore. What can we do in such a case?
Yeah, this is a situation when you can't see the line. Here, for example, also on the picture, we're going to launch a detector next year as well. And the laser, even when you can't see, the laser detector going to catch the line and guides the user to the center of your reference mark. The detector delivers up to 50 meters of visibility and is comparable to all our lasers we're coming into the market.
Hey, and again, 50 meters in one direction. So 100 meter total range in total with the detector. Is this right?
Easy.
Easy. And this is the moment where the first questions come in, Raphael. We have here the first one, and I think this is a really important one. Are they still in development for now, or are our lasers close to be available in the stores?
Yeah, we still have here a soft launch for Europe, and UK will start next year. And for the whole entire laser range you saw today, it will be January. Are they IP rated? Yes, they're IP rated. All our lasers have an IP rating of 54.
Hey, when I check the questions from our audience, there are no more questions left. I think your explanation was that good that we don't need to go. Ah, one more. How much runtime do we have with one battery?
Okay, again, on the Red Lithium USB, we have more than 8 hours of runtime. And on the M12, we're going to have on both models over 15 hours of runtime.
Here comes an important question from Noah. I think this is really something a lot of people will ask. Raphael, what is the precision of our lasers on 10 meter?
Yeah, the precision on 10 meter is 3 millimeter on all the lasers.
And then I have on, that would be epic. I asked my supplier a couple days ago and he said he didn't know nothing about the lasers. So I was a bit disappointed. Now he hopes, hopefully everything.
He knows no more, yeah. Absolutely.
Hi, Claude, Rafa. I give the question direct to Rafa. The question goes not to me. If the 12 volt has a radius of 76 meter, what is the radius of the 4 volt?
Be careful. The 12 volts has a radius of 38 meter and a diameter of 76. And the 4 volt, correct, I think we missed this, is 30 meter in radius and 60 meter on a diameter.
Perfect. And are they supplied in cases, Raphael?
Yeah, very good questions. They're all supplied in cases. And even the zero versions come in cases. And the cases also allows to put all these accessories into the cases.
So, but for now, any more questions, guys? We are still here. We have 2 hours time till the next webinar starts. So feel free and ask.
Fragen? Es gibt noch Fragen, haben wir gehört.
Yes. Is the magnetic bracket detachable?
The magnetic bracket is not detachable. Only in the as a service part, when it breaks, it can be detached from service, from our service, and can make a new one on it.
Raphael, I think the next one is even an important one. Oops. Do we offer any kind of calibration for the lasers? I think I switched this one off. Huh?
Yeah, we use here third parties to calibrate the tools, to verify them, to also offer you here a certification if it's needed on job sites.
Will other receivers work with our Milwaukee lasers? So I think the question goes, can we use, for example, a Bosch detector and a Milwaukee laser?
Yeah, other detector lasers, line laser detectors, will work with Milwaukee laser. We not recommend this to use it. We not guarantee here any accuracy. But when we tried it, yes, it works.
I think I saw here one, which comes from Thomas. This is could be interesting because we didn't speak too much about it. Do we offer any special glasses here? And I would add, do we need this?
Okay, first of all, we have to split it. Safety glasses are not needed for laser class 2. Okay. Visibility glasses to make the line more visible. When we spoke to end users, really the feedback was, we don't use it. Okay. Most of the time they were still in the packaging, laying in the box. They were not touching it. That was our decision because what we see on the job site was they're not using it. So we decided we're not going to have it.
Okay. Then comes from Noah, just a quick one. This I can answer. IP54. So this is also what we know from the market, what most of the lasers
on
have.
On all lasers.
Yeah. And also the competitors.
Absolutely.
So it is not high, it is not low, it is absolute market standard what a customer expects today.
Yeah. Yeah. And we're focusing here on indoor use with the line lasers.
Okay, here comes one. I think we need to precise again. How about visibility in more broad light environment? Here definitely we have to help her.
What is how broad?
I would say the question goes a little, how can we improve the visibility in high or in bright areas?
Well, yeah, we have solutions like the target blade, we said, which is reflecting the line and illuminates the line. Or then in combination with our detector, when you can't see the line, the detector will always catch the line and guides you where you need to go.
Yeah, and there comes direct the next question from Sergey to the detector. Is the detector included in the kit or
not?
Not.
No, the detector will be not be included in the kit. It will be an accessories for the launch, for the first launch. To not tell,
I think it is important to explain why we do not include the detector, because what we know from the research, a lot of customers wouldn't use the detector. We saw it especially on some dedicated user groups, right?
High demand users like drywallers, they usually use detectors. Our core users like electrician, plumbers, and HVAC, we saw barely they're using here a detector, yes.
Yeah, Raphael, one more comes from anonymous. It's always fine if you go, if you enter the webinar and you don't give in your name. So I have a lot of questions from anonymous here.
Anonymous, yeah.
And from anonymous comes another one. What's about durability?
Yeah, durability. We're going to have here 1 meter drop, what we guarantee. And the IP54 speaks for his own.
And one more to the receiver. Is it showing in millimeter or just arrows to go up and down?
It just shows arrows here in the line laser receiver.
Raphael, I think it is a good idea. We had such a lot of questions to the receiver. Let's show the picture again. I think, yeah, when we go to the picture, we can see the arrows clearly. Also, what you see in the picture now in the background, maybe we can ask our guy on the camera to go a bit closer there. Also, what you can see now is really the bright area where the laser line is not visible. When we go now on the detector, we see clearly the arrow, which indicates us where to move. Okay. Any more questions here? A question again about a case. No, it is not a pack-out case, I think. It was a special case for the lasers, right, Raphael?
Yeah, we have a BMC case here, a plastic case for the red lithium USB lasers, also for the M12 lasers. On the M12 laser, we also add here a nice foam material, which really protects the lasers really, really good.
Okay. I don't see at the moment any more questions. Raphael? Okay.
Thank you very much here from my side. Thanks for joining this webinar. And I hope I see you guys on the next laser webinar. I'm sure most of you definitely want to get in touch with the lasers. And once you have them, hey, enjoy it.
Yeah, guys. Also, thank you from my side for joining us today. And I would not see you in the next laser webinar. I would see you in 2 weeks' time when we go for our carbide webinar. Yes, thank you very much. Have a relaxing weekend and then a productive time with Milwaukee Lasers. Thank you very much and goodbye.